Coming up, Jonathan visits the Florida Aquarium in Tampa, where he meets Theo the pelican and dives with sand tiger sharks. Welcome to Jonathan Bird's Blue World.
There are a lot of great attractions in Florida, and they're not all in Orlando. I'm in Tampa at the Florida Aquarium, and this place is incredible.
The Florida Aquarium is hard to miss, with its giant glass roof allowing natural light into a huge wetlands exhibit. I'm meeting up with Associate Curator Eric Hovland for a tour of the facility.
Hey, Eric!
Hey, Jonathan!
How are you?
Doing terrific. Yeah, welcome to the Florida Aquarium.
Thank you. What are we going to do today?
We're going to experience the entire aquarium from the mangrove forest all the way to the coral reefs, and we're going to get you in the water with my favorite animals, sand tiger sharks.
All right, let's go!
Let's go get wet.
Our first stop on the tour is the mangrove forest.
And you're going to see a mangrove forest in here that we've grown from propagules to now where it's pushing against the ceiling.
This healthy mangrove survives entirely on natural light.
Now we're gonna come over to some alligators.
Oh, look at that dude, huh?
Yeah, they're beautiful girls. And what's really great is when you think about them, you can relate their behavior more and more to birds. They nest, they care for their young, they have mating calls, the young call to their mother to unnest them, to help them out of the nest, and then they protect their young for a bit while they're young.
Within the mangrove exhibit, we also meet the American river otters, who are full of energy.
We have Otto, he's the elder. He is 20 years old now, and that's one of the oldest otters, American river otters, that you'll see in any aquarium or zoo environment. Look right around the corner here to Theo.
Hey, Theo.
Theo is a young brown pelican. He's still getting to know everybody. He's been with us now a couple of months. He's very curious.
Does he just walk around just like he owns the place?
While we're getting open? Yeah, because, you know, he does own the place. It's here for him. Yep. And then he'll be back up in his habitat before we open up our doors.
But now it's time to go check out my habitat. There are lots of smaller exhibits featuring things like octopods, pipefish and seahorses, jellies, and bottom-dwelling animals like slipper lobsters and batfish. Larger exhibits have tarpon, Goliath groupers, and sea turtles, among other things. But the largest exhibit, the coral reef habitat, has 500,000 gallons of seawater.
Wow, look at this.
This is where we want you to just, you know, press your face right up against it, get up as close as you can. That's, you're gonna get even closer though.
That is cool. Look at the viewing of this.
And sand tiger sharks.
Woo, I want this in my living room. Hey, what's up, dude? He's like, look at me.
Yeah.
I'm cool.
They're truly gorgeous.
I'm a shark.
I mean, look at that smile.
Look at these teeth.
There's like five smiles in there with rows and rows of smiles. A lot of folks think, you know, why aren't those sharks eating everything in there? And it's kind of the same thing, you know, with us. You mean, you eat when you need to, and when food is available to you, we target feed the animals. We feed our turtle at one station, our sand tigers at another, our cuda, our eels, everybody. They all have their place at the table. And really, they have their needs met, and they have the space to explore, and they have stimulation and wellness. That's important for all of them. We take it very seriously, the care and wellness of our animals, and to be able to be involved from the very beginning. We know their history, we know that they are, you know, brought out of sustainable areas, the science backs that up to show that we're doing this environmentally soundly, and it lets us share a part of Florida that even Floridians don't get to see, much less the, you know, 800,000 or so people that come here every year to visit the Florida Aquarium. And the guests will come and see our sharks, and not just see sharks, but see our divers and our guest divers interacting in the water safely and having a great time with sharks. And it can really change that mentality of shark-infested waters. I like to think shark-enhanced waters. Yeah. You know, you're excited and lucky to see a shark in the wild. That's a good sign. And if you can see people interacting with sharks and our turtle and everybody else in here, you can even take a chance to hop in the water yourself. A swim with the shark program or a dive with the sharks program that we have here, and get to know them yourself up close and personal.
And now it's time for me to get up close and personal with the sharks on a dive in the habitat.
Three, two,
First, cameraman Todd and I head over to the briefing room to sign some waivers and get a quick lesson in how the dive is conducted. Then it's time to head to the dive platform.
Divers are changed out, heading to the...
Todd and I each have a dive buddy from the aquarium dive staff. Todd and his buddy Wayne Philibert are gearing up first. Then Wayne demonstrates the proper technique for entering the water. Now, you might notice that they're entering into a shark cage. This isn't to protect them from sharks, but to protect the habitat from potentially inexperienced divers. Once they're in the water with their buoyancy under control, Todd and Wayne can exit the cage. Next, it's my turn. I follow my buddy Jamie Kearney into the water. Like a bad 70s movie, there's already sharks circling the cage. Jamie and I submerge and exit to the shark-enhanced waters. If you think the view from outside the glass is good, you should see how amazing the view is from inside. Many of the fish in here have become fond of the tickling feel of sand being sprinkled on them. When Jamie starts playing with the sand, fish come in from all directions. But the Goliath grouper likes the feel of bubbles on his lips. I think the barracuda is jealous. It seems we have become part of the exhibit. Our grouper buddy behind, we sneak down a hidden passage to find the resident green moray eel. Then back out into the main section of the exhibit to film some sharks. Sand tigers are perfect for aquaria because the teeth look really scary, but in reality, the sharks are totally docile. And since the reef itself is made of fiberglass, I have a nice place to sit and enjoy the view. There's even a resident nurse shark. They don't swim around too much, so I'm lucky to catch this one making a pass by the camera. In many aquaria, the fish just swim in circles, but the complex shape of this exhibit encourages the animals to swim in all different directions. I wave to Zach, filming from outside, as I make my way to the observation tunnel. The sharks love to make passes by this tunnel, much to the delight of the guests. Boy, do they come close to my camera. A southern stingray is a little confused because we're blocking the normal path. Eventually, it's time to head back up to the surface. I give a wave to the kids as I head over to the steps.
Well, that was the fishiest dive ever. There are more fish in here than you'll see in the ocean in about 3 or 4 dives. Woo. Well, it felt cold when I went in, but it's even colder getting out. Actually, the water's pretty warm.
The Florida Aquarium in Tampa is a spectacular glimpse into the underwater world. Their exhibits cover a range of habitats from freshwater to salt and include a lot of wildlife native to Florida. And you don't have to be special to dive in their coral reef habitat with the sharks. Any certified diver can participate in this program, and it's an incredible way to encounter a wide variety of life in the blue world. Hey everyone! Thanks for watching our latest episode all the way to the end. Hit that subscribe button now so you won't miss our next episode. And check out our new second channel, Blue World Plus, for some awesome behind-the-scenes vlogs and extras.